Welcome to Prince George's Community College's celebration of the Excellence Awards. Tonight, we celebrate you, our stars. Please welcome to the stage our celebrity guest host for the evening, TV radio host personality, sports analyst, commentator, actor, voiceover talent, host, MC, and music producer, the epitome of multi-hyphenated talent, the incomparable Wes Hall.
Give a shout out to DJ Heat real quick. Gotta give a shout out to DJ Heat. Familia. So first and foremost, before I get into the formalities, how's everybody doing today? You all look good. I see you got dressed up. We're about to give out some awards. We got some hardware up here. How's everybody feeling today? I know the weather's been kind of wanky. Everybody good? All right, all right. Ready for the weekend? Even though today's Thursday, in my world, weekend starts Thursday night at like 8 o'clock. Well, I want to welcome everybody to Prince George's Community College. First of all, you obviously look good, but we're going to celebrate excellence tonight. When it comes to excellence, it cannot always be recognized, but when it is, you put your hands together and make sure everybody can hear you because the work has been done. Now it's time to reward it. So I want to welcome you to the third annual Prince George's Community College Excellence Awards. Give yourselves a round of applause. We're going to be celebrating service years, employee of the year, and new employee of the year, and this is the ultimate award given out tonight. President Falecia Williams, President's Award recipient. So shout out to everybody who will be recognized. Now, I thought about something when I was coming up to the stage. I was like, they probably don't really know who I really am, what I really do. So let me go ahead and tell you. There's a small basketball team in the area. I don't know if you know them. They may... The Washington Wizards, is that who? Yeah. So I host the pre and post game shows for Washington Wizards. It's called Wizards Pre and Post Game Live on Monumental Sports Network. Also host Beyond the Buzzer, Greatest Sports Legends Now and Then. Done a few movies, done a couple songs and all that good stuff. But that's what got me here today. But the reason I'm standing here today is because a good friend of mine called me and said, brother, I've got this opportunity for you to give out an award to some really dope people. And I want to make sure that it's handled with care. And he said, I get to wear a suit. And I said, that's all you had to tell me, because otherwise I'm in my sweats all day long. So I want to give a shout out to Dr. Williams. You and Prince George's Community College leadership should be commended for celebrating the Excellent Awards. It's a great take, and it's really an honor to make the time to acknowledge superstars. That's what you are. When you get an award for something, you're a superstar. So tonight, it's going to be a star-studded night. I want you to give yourselves another round of applause because we're going to greet members of the college's Board of Trustees if you're in the room. Also, Foundation Board if you're in the room, and don't forget the senior team as well. So sit back. Relax, you're already sitting down. I was thinking about making you get up, but I ain't gonna do that to you today. We're gonna sit back a little bit. We're gonna have some fun. We're gonna celebrate. We've got music, we've got entertainment, and of course, we're gonna honor employee excellence at Prince George's Community College. So, once again, shout out to DJ Heat. Matter of fact, I got a question. Does anybody have a birthday today? Anybody got a birthday close to today? Anybody have a birthday this week? Oh, I saw a hand. Was that you? Oh, you're just telling your friend I'm sit down. Who's got a birthday? Are there any Wizards fans in the room? That's really, I got something for you. Can I see that thing? Let me get that one real quick. I might as well take that too. Ooh, no. See, I saw that. See, when I asked it the first time, you didn't want to say nothing. Yeah, that's for you. Happy birthday, my dear. I'm gonna slide it to you. That's a Jordan Poole bobblehead for you, courtesy of the Wizards. Now, you, my dear, first of all, you got pandas on. Love those sneakers. This is for you. This is a Jordan Poole jersey, courtesy of the Washington Wizards, just for you, my dear. You have a great night. All right, now I feel better. DJ Heat, crank up a little bit of music and let them know how we do this thing up in the heat. Ooh, yeah. First of all, who knows? Where are my Team Marie fans at in the building? Old school, yeah. Tina and Rick James back in the day. You can get up and dance if you want. I'm not going to judge you, even though I probably will. Well, here's the deal. DJ Heat's going to keep the music going all night. I want to get you the show because you're not here to watch me talk. You're here to watch yourselves receive awards. So, without further ado, guys, it is my honor and pleasure to present the esteemed president of Prince George's Community College, the one and only Dr. Falecia Williams.
Thank you, Wes. Good evening, everyone. Good evening. Okay, you all have done the typical thing. You have gone to the outside of the room, started in the back. That's okay. We're going to get there. But good evening, everyone. Welcome to the third annual Excellence Awards for Prince George's Community College. I'm Dr. Falecia Williams. I am the proud president of this great institution, and it is truly my pleasure to be with you this evening to celebrate excellence at PGCC. It gives me great pride and joy to honor those of you who have demonstrated tremendous hard work. You're here because you see our students succeed, and you're committed to advancing our institutional goals. On behalf of the PGCC community, I want to express my utmost gratitude and say thank you to you for going the extra mile. Thank you for paying attention to the details. Thank you for always seeking to improve. And thank you for pushing through challenges and more challenges and more challenges and more challenges, but doing so with extreme fortitude. Thank you for showing up in every space that you have been invited, and in some places that you weren't. But we thank you for being there. Achieving excellence isn't easy, but it is necessary. Excellence matters, and it's what makes the difference for our institution as well as for our students. Each of you is a role model for our campus, demonstrating what it is to be a part of something that is bigger than yourself. During this evening ceremony, colleagues will be awarded for an impressive 5 to 40 years of service at Prince George's Community College. Can you imagine the people at the back end, the 40 years? All right? All right. We will also celebrate Employees of the Year. There's so many people who are doing phenomenal work here, but we dare to choose to identify one by category that is excelling in an extraordinary way. Would you just give yourselves a huge round of applause tonight? For everyone that is being honored tonight, it is truly an accomplishment. Your dedication, your contributions add value to our organization. You are abundantly appreciated. And our effort tonight is simply to robustly and profoundly say thank you. Inside this room tonight are people who represent the best of Prince George's Community College, and that is a great honor to carry. Congratulations to each of you. I am most proud of you. And I invite you to bask in the glory of tonight's festivities because you have earned it. And because tomorrow, everybody's just going to expect you to come back and do exactly what you had to do today. But seriously, enjoy tonight. Too often we move on so quickly. But if we can all commit to pausing tonight and really just celebrating people in the moment for the good that they have achieved and the excellence that they have demonstrated, because it means a lot. Now, are you ready? Yes. Let the celebration begin. All right.
First of all, I'm jealous that you got Cool in the Gang.
All right.
I like music.
That's DJ Heat.
Yeah, facts. We will facts. Be talking later. But I want to thank you, Dr. Williams. First of all, it's an honor to share the stage with you. Your advocacy for this institution is well known beyond the walls of this institution. So it is a true testament to all the labor that you and everyone that is under your guide that have actually put into work. So thank you very much for being so much.
Thank
Give
you.
Her a round of applause, please.
Thank you.
Now, as we are giving people rounds of applause, I feel it is only fair that we continue to get into the show.
All
is that fair with you? Is that fine with
That's
you?
That's fair. Let's do it.
All right. So now I have to be honest, while preparing to be here with you this evening, I learned about this thing called constituency groups. Is that a thing? Is that a thing around here? Well, I heard it was based on job function, grades, and classifications, learning institution, hello, I'm doing it in real time. But these constituency groups, they meet periodically to discuss common interests and goals, and your leaders, well, they decide to discuss some of those interests and find out how that way they can build an environment for shared governance. So for the Excellence Awards, each Prince George's Community College constituency group and the AFSCME Union searched, nominated, and selected their employees of the year. And so for those of you who exemplify the college's core commitments and consistently provide exemplary work performance, I think I got them memorized. Tell me if I get them wrong, all right? Students first, is that right?
All right,
I got that. I got an A in this class. Class dismissed. Achievement, is that one? All right. Equity. Oh, look at me getting A's today. I feel good. Continuous improvement.
Yes.
I might have a doc. Y'all hiring around here?
I'm
feeling real confident
right now.
How about empathy? Is empathy one of them? Oh, now I know this last one because I find it to be the most important one, whether you're in this institution or not. It is integrity.
Yeah.
And integrity. I cannot tell you how important that is to have. So, Dr. Williams, are you ready to get this thing going for real?
I'm ready. Are you ready?
Ooh.
Are you all ready?
No, they don't sound ready. They don't sound ready.
You're
going to clap if you're ready to get this thing going. There we go. That's the energy we want. So the first contingency group we'll celebrate this evening will be technical and support staff organization representing frontline employees who make day-to-day operations and face-to-face engagements successful. The TSSL full-time employee of the year is Ms. Megan Henderson, coordinator of the event management and financial services and operations area. Now, Ms. Henderson is unavailable to be with us this evening. However, TSSO President Lieutenant Barbara Smith will receive the reward in her honor.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Congratulations. Take a picture. There we go. Photog's right there in the middle. Give her a round of applause once again. All right, next up, the Administrative and Professional Staff Organization. They bring together college leadership, supervisors, and managers. And tonight's APSO Excellent Award recipient is Miss Barbara Denman. There you go. Barbara Denman is the Dean of Professional Studies and Community Education and Teaching, Learning, and Student Success Area. She's joined by APSO President, Miss Jasmine Jones Hopewell.
Thank you.
Congratulations once again. Now, the college also has a collective bargaining unit. Coming from the world of the NBA and professional sports, collective bargaining is something I'm quite familiar with. But AFSCME Local 1646 is also involved. So ACME is proud to honor its part-time excellent award recipient, Mr. Pernell Benjamin. Now, Mr. Benjamin is a member of the college's Environmental Services Staff and Financial Services and Operations Area. He is joined by AFSCME Local 1646 Union President, Mrs. Tammy Cameron Allen. Well done indeed, well done indeed.
Stay right there.
Everybody's getting awards out here. I'm handing them out. So, now the union's full-time excellent awards recipient is Ms. Cheryl Connor. Ms. Connor is an Office Associate 3 in the nursing department on the college's teaching, learning, and student success areas. So give her a round of applause.
Congratulations to you. I'm going to look straight at it.
Well done. I say we give a big round of applause to all of our recipients. Now, Dr. Williams, you got ends with my DJ.
All right.
And I'm supposed to tell DJ Heat what to do, but do you want to tell DJ Heat what to do? All right. DJ Heat, you know how we get down in Cap One Arena. Would you mind showing the people how we get down from the perch? Shout out to DJ Heat. Here's some music, and we're going to keep this thing going. How about a couple of minutes so everybody can settle in? And once again, shake hands and speak to your neighbor and congratulate the big winners.
Or stand up and dance.
I like that too. Let's step on over to this one. That's energy right there. I feel young. Yes. All right. Yeah. See, you notice how I conveniently disappeared during that time. I was like, yeah. The way these knees are built after what I done, I'm all about this clap. There you go. Give him a round of applause, ladies. Again, give it up to DJ Heat. Great selection of songs to get the people moving, as we always appreciate it. But this is an awards program, so we have more awards to present this evening. Now, we're going to celebrate Prince George's Community College Service Years honorees. And by service years, we're talking about those employees who are celebrating 5, 10, 15, 20 years of employment at the college and more. But I can't do this on my own. I think I need the proverbial voice in the sky to help me. Is that all right with you, voice?
Indeed. Hello, Wes.
Okay. It's not Siri. I might have to call Ebony. I like that. Yeah. Hey, Ebony, you mind helping me out real quick? How about this? Take it away, voice, and I will gladly fade once again.
Thank you, Wes. Service Years honorees, please join Dr. Falecia Williams on stage as your names are called. Don't wait to hear your name. Begin walking when your service years are called. Our 5-year honorees: Deborah Abba, Ayad Abdul-Jabbar, Janae Anderson, Janette Armstrong, Varga Azad, Obeidullah Bahich, Carol Barthel, Angela Billingsley, Eric Booth, Deborah Bowles, Robin Boyer, Ramon Braza, Yasmin Brown, Carl Burnett, Raymond Butler, Kayon Campbell, Heath Kerlock, Jerry Comparativo, Laurel Convoy, Denise Cruz, Carla Crump, Sylvester Douglas, Kelly Dragon, Jinwan Duan, Mernush Imami, Mary Ertzik, Amira Frazier, Amani Frazier, Elena Gay, Tracy Gray, Tanya Greenfeld, Dwight Harvin, James Holloman III, Victor Humain, Erica Jackson, Marilyn Jean, Marie Jean-Pierre, Trinity Jennings, Shanice Jones, Shari Jurek, Svetlana Konova, Kujo Kamadi, Thomas Lardner, Edmund Lazari, Cynthia Lopez, Ira Luke III, James McKnight III, Bernard Mbanka, Adrian Miller, E. Keith Mervin, Joe Nader, Jason Novick, Laura Nwokafor, Adewimi Olubawi, Paria Parto, Dillies Pilewski, Binya Pittman, Alberta Pleasant, Jeffrey Potter, Lynn Powell, Donald Pruitt, Karen Radston Vereen, Clayton Raley, Philip Ravita, Nicholas Reed, Devin Richards, Nicholas Robinson, Charles Robinson Jr., Charles Rogers Jr., Sanika Romulus, Richard Saunders, Trevin Setman, Courtney Smith, Tomzalu Staples, Ann Stoddard, Sherita Thompson, Ron Weiss Jr., Jennifer Wells, Daniel Wilburn, Demetrius Williams, Emmanuel Willis, Laura Wilson, and Wynn Hills Zhang. Let's give them all a round of applause. There will be lots of opportunities for our Service Years awardees in the atrium to take lots of photos at the end of the evening. Honorees, be sure to stop by the award station and pick up your award at the conclusion of the program. And now, our 10-year service awards recipients. Please join Dr. Williams on stage. Remember, don't wait for your name. Start walking now. Dominic Barnwell, Kenneth Chapman, Sharon Childs, Nicole Clark, Stephanie Daschle, Jonathan Dorsey, Dora Fowler, Virginie Hardesty, Joy Herndon, Sarah Hyatt, Carla Johnson, Jarrell Keys, Muhammad Khan, Jennifer Kim, Cindy Lee, Raleigh Lucas, Julie Salcetti, Veronica Seward, Rahila Siddiqui, Janelle Simpson, Marquino Stewart, Rachel Tonight, Kara Thomas, O'Shea Thomas, Mark Trembley, Jennifer Underwood, and Kathy Yorkshire. Let's give our 10-year service awards recipients a round of applause. Remember to take lots of photos in the atrium and pick up your awards at the award station after the program. Now let's celebrate the college's 15-year service awards recipients. Please join Dr. Williams on stage now. Lynn Austin, Ben Bazizu, Gina Bush, Sharon Bird, Melanie Connie Soyoye, Rudell Daniel, Cynthia Duckett, Consuelo Dunnington, Michael Ellis, Stanislaw Ibwoma, Daniel Foss, Veronica Fernandez, Beverly Harvey, William Wilma Jennings, Terry Jodry, Marshall Johnson, Matokio Jones, Crispin Capone, Maurice Klein, Robert Lewis, Angela McPherson, Janine Ninjastu, Kendra Miller, Gina Nightingale, Kathleen Owens, Ryan P., James Rahman, Mary Retort George, Crystal Smith, Katha Stewart, Earl Williams, and Dana Wood. Let's congratulate our 15-year service awards recipients. Congratulations. Remember to pick up your awards at the award station. The following employees are celebrating 20 years of employment with Prince George's Community College. Please join Dr. Williams on stage now. Ennis Allen, Clover Baker Brown, Sonia Bell, Ivan Biss, Beth Cruz, Antoinette Doherty, Colina January, Vivian Kwewogi, Fatima Lamar Taylor, Don Lewis, Christy McGee, Cassandra Moore Crawford, Killy Nagby, Marvin Palmer, Rhonda Spells Ventry, Miriam Terrain, Sarah Wegner, and Sherelle Williams. You are outstanding. Get your cameras ready for our celebration in the atrium. Celebration of employee excellence continues as we acknowledge employees who have been with the college for 25 years. Honorees, please join Dr. Williams on stage as your names are called. Manuel Arrington. Beth Baldwin. Diane Corbin. Bernadette Dampley. Diane Finley is unable to be with us this evening. Robert Gatewood. Mary Hardy. Theodore Herman. Takima Jackson. Linda Jenkins. Titus Mingo. Puspanjali Misra. Don Powell. Bernadette Stout Prince. Maria Foundale, Bridget Watson, congratulations to all of our 25-year recipients. Congratulations to our 30-year recipient, Mount Fulcher, Ava Johnson, Carl Carlson, William Lloyd, Ilana Robinson, Benward Swartz, and Thomas Swari Tekumala. 35 years of employment, Professor Thomas Wasaki. Let's congratulate our awardees from 5 to 35 years. Dr. Falecia Williams will now continue the award celebration.
It has truly been exciting to see all of our awardees tonight, but these next two are simply amazing. First, celebrating 40 years of employment at Prince George's Community College. Say, she didn't say four. Just tell your neighbor, she didn't say four. She said 40 years of employment. Please help me celebrate Mrs. Eileen Flagg. Serves as the senior PC analyst in e-learning services in our data science, innovation, and effectiveness area. She is amazing. Our second employee, also celebrating 40 years of employment, is Professor Rocco Manella. Rocco Manella. He works in the college's Natural Sciences Department of Teaching, Learning, and Student Success. Wow. 40 years. Did y'all see Rocco? He came. No. Season. 40 years. That's incredible. And it's a very long time to do anything. Congratulations to Mrs. Flagg and Professor Manella. And to all of our Service Year Award recipients, would you give everyone a huge round of applause? Now, for a moment, where we choose to pause and to reflect, because as much as it is a celebratory occasion, we also know that there are those who once were with us, but aren't anymore. So we also pause to remember those who have transitioned since our last celebration. So I invite you to turn your attention to the screens for a very special tribute.
Some difficult days ahead, but it really doesn't matter with me now, because I've been to the mountaintop. I don't mind. Like anybody, I would like to live a long life. Longevity has its place, but I'm not concerned about that now. I just want to do God's will. And He's allowed me to go up to the mountain. And I've looked over and I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you, but I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land.
My fitting tribute to those who were friends and colleagues. It's always wonderful to take a moment to recognize them. And obviously we continue to celebrate the life and legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. forever. Right now we're going to take a brief 10-minute intermission. Piggy's going to play some music. I want you to rise, recognize, and just take some moments to enjoy each other in the present moment. I think that's important to do today. What do you say? Is that cool with you? All right. So in 10 minutes, we'll be right back here to continue on with the show.
What led you to this pathway?
You know what? I need to get into the field of educating officers to make sure that they do the right thing. And that's why I ended up here at Prince George Community College.
All righty. We still got some awards to give out. We got more fun to have. So is everybody ready for the latter part of this endeavor? feel like I'm on the airplane, I'm like, you're in an emergency row. Are you competent enough to open the door? I always say, yeah. I'm not going to stand there and wait on y'all. I'm going to open the door. The rest is on you. but now, as President Williams returns back to the stage once again, the celebration continues with the Faculty Organization Excellence Awards. And so the Faculty Organization is a constituency group that unites all faculty, full and part-time, under the umbrella of teaching, learning, and student success. So I think we can appreciate that. So please welcome the full-time Faculty Organization Excellence Award recipient, Associate Professor Glenn Giebler. Glenn, come on up. He teaches in the Natural Sciences Department of the Teaching, Learning, and Student Success area. Professor Giebler is joined by Faculty Organization President Assistant Professor John Mack. So John Mack, come up to the stage as well. Very, very happy. All right, feel free to hang out with us if you want. I'm looking for Mr. Carl, aka Rick Carlson. Where's Carl? Rick! My left, oh, he's not here. Well, guess what? He's the Faculty Organization's part-time Faculty Excellence Award recipient, and he teaches in the Mathematics Department. Right. So give him some love. Now, obviously, he's unable to be with us tonight. However, Professor Mack's going to receive the award on his behalf. Once again, showing love. We appreciate that. Dr. Williams, we're about to have a special moment, because coming to the stage is Dr. Rhonda Spells Fentry. Yeah, Vice President of Data Science, Innovation, and Effectiveness for a special presentation. I think this is a treat for us all. So if you don't mind, you and I'll step aside and let her have a go.
Let's do that.
Allez, on y va.
Good evening. I have the distinct honor of presenting the new Employee of the Year Award. For the second year in a row, the new Employee of the Year is in the Data Science, Innovation, and Effectiveness area. This year's new Employee of the Year Award recipient began her tenure at the college in August of 2022. From our initial interaction during her interview process, it was evident she possessed an exceptional blend of talent, dedication, and passion for student success. And we knew that day that the college would be a better place because of her. In her short time at the college, she has fostered relationships across the college to bridge gaps in online learning processes and practices impacting students. She spearheaded innovative initiatives tailored towards enhancing the online student experience. She's demonstrated remarkable leadership qualities while fostering a collaborative and inclusive work environment. Most notably, her e-learning partnership with the Student Governance Association to ensure student voices are considered in e-learning decisions has really been remarkable. A few of her accomplishments. She partnered with the SGA to provide an e-learning SGA online student survey in fall of 22. Remember, she started in August, so in just a few months, she was already connected with students. She led an effort to facilitate ensuring headphones were available in all computer labs to allow students to participate in structured remote classes from the on-campus computer labs. She led a work group comprised of faculty and staff from TLSS and Student Affairs to evaluate and select a new online tutoring service. And one member of the committee indicated, "This is the most efficient committee I've served on since I arrived at the college." What truly sets her apart is her unwavering dedication to students first and her genuine commitment to understanding and addressing the needs of our online students. Her ability to prioritize the student experience and advocate for their interests sets her apart as a true champion for the college's mission and values. Since her arrival, she has not only been actively engaged in e-learning, but has also presented online student support initiatives at both local and national conferences. a quote from a nomination letter written for her sums up her awesomeness. And I quote, "In my quarter century at the college, there have been few employees with whom I have interacted who stand out so quickly in their talents and dedication." And I agree. Ladies and gentlemen, I am excited to present Prince George's Community College's new Employee of the Year, Ms. Lindsay Barclay, e-learning coordinator of Online Student Success.
So once again, we are at that place in the program where we celebrate the President's Award. And I think as we envision what the President's Award means, I would just want to take a moment to say any number of people in our organization could be selected for the President's Award. You're really that remarkable, and you're doing phenomenal work. But we have the opportunity to really tease out a level of excellence that is not only about one's individual achievements, but that are about the kinds of achievements that make other people better, make our institution stronger, and dramatically advance our student outcomes. So it's to that end that we endeavor each year to identify people who represent that extraordinary that we're daring to become as an institution. So I stand really humbled and honored to share with you the profile of President's Award recipients, because I share what you share with me about how they have impacted the college and your work. This recipient has been a full-time faculty member at Prince George's Community College since January of 2003. She earned tenure in 2008 and was promoted to a full-time professor in 2015. She originally served as the coordinator for the LPN program, team lead for Nursing 2010, which was the pediatric nursing course. She accepted the role of interim department chair for nursing in May of 2019 and assumed the standing role in January of 2020. She has been a leader in all aspects of her work, and she didn't wait for a position or a title to begin making significant contributions to student learning or collegial advancement. She previously served as an academic advisor for third semester nursing students. She was co-chair of the curriculum committee and a member of the multicultural committee. Service is a central theme in her work ethos. She is a courageous change agent. She successfully led faculty efforts to turn around the low NCLEX pass rates, thereby returning the program to full approval of the Maryland Board of Nursing. And yes, it's remarkable. It's remarkable. And I know this. She would definitely say it was a we. She would say it was the team. So I know this. And continuing accreditation to let you know the jeopardy that the program was in at the time. Dean Angie Anderson remarked that the Maryland Board of Nursing was so impressed with the faculty's ability to turn around the program and to get the pass rates above the benchmark that they are still to this day referring programs that are in jeopardy
to our award recipient for assistance, guidance, and consultation. She displays the critical thinking and the ingenuity that she also inspires in students as well as her colleagues. She was instrumental in infusing clinical simulation into the nursing curriculum. She has been a principal investigator, an author, and a project lead for grant funding totaling nearly $4 million in just the last 5 years. Impressive. Grants through Maryland's Nursing Support Program, the Health Resources and Services Administration, known as HRSA, and we are a recipient of congressionally directed spending. She collaborated with Client Solutions to successfully create Prince George's Community College's first state-approved apprenticeship program in patient care technician. She admirably navigated the challenge of program continuity during the COVID-19 pandemic. PGCC was the only nursing program that was not displaced from clinicals during the pandemic. She's a fantastic wife, a mother, and a grandmother, who was awarded the Multicultural Champion Award by Prince George's County Office of Community Outreach. And she achieved Academic Nurse Educator Certification Award from the Maryland Higher Education Commission last year. So she has not sat down on her laurels. She's continued to grow, continued to achieve. Would you join me in celebrating Prince George's Community College President's Awards recipient for 2024, Ms. Vivian P. Kuwagi. On most days, I would be saying, that's all, folks. We'd be heading for the tables. But this year, there's another President's Award recipient. Remember what I said? There are so many of you that could be selected for this award. But that also tells you the excellence that we have among us, the outstanding peers and colleagues that are right here in our midst. Our next recipient has worked at Prince George's Community College for over 39 years. She launched the college's first women's soccer team and served as its head coach from 1997 to 2004. In 2005, she began her current role as the Owls Athletic Director. The Owls have won 55 NJCAA Region 20 titles, and over 100 student athletes have received NJCAA All-American status under her leadership. That's prominent. But if you ask her, she is most proud and widely recognized for her focus on the student and the title of student athlete. Because academics and the students' completion of their academic credentials and degrees are the essential focus of her athletic department. She runs a tight ship, and she holds her coaches as well as the student athletes to task. She is a huge contributor at the conference, the regional, and the national levels. She is an advocate of the Maryland Junior College Athletic Conference and currently serves as treasurer. She is a Region 20 representative on the NJCAA Board of Regents and has served as the women's chair since 2005. Her work on national committees is exemplary and she's highly sought after by new athletic directors for her expertise and her pearls of wisdom. She's highly decorated in her field. In April 2018, she was named the recipient of the Mary Ellen Light Service Award for the National Junior College Athletic Conference. Founded in 1959, the NJCAA Service Award is the most tenured honor handed out by the association. It is given to those, most often not an athlete, who have made significant contributions to two-year college athletics on a national level for an extended period of time. In April 2022, she was named a recipient of the George E. Killian Award of Excellence, again from the National Junior College Athletic Association. This award, founded in 2006, is an award of excellence, and it has been given annually to individuals who have demonstrated the ideals of volunteerism, achievement, service, leadership, and excellence for its namesake, George E. Killian. He was one of the most influential leaders in the history of the association. She, too, is a proud wife, a mother, and a grandmother. And she is handy with the tools. She knows her way around skills trades. Dr. Tyson Beale said, "She has provided exemplary service to the college. Her commitment and dedication to our athletics department and overall student success framework are commendable and celebrated near and far. Student Affairs is grateful for her longstanding contributions at Prince George's Community College." A former student, Leonardo Silver, who was also a student athlete, he said, "She's an incredible woman, a professional with a huge heart that does everything possible to empower and mentor students who she comes in contact with." Would you join me in celebrating our 2024 President's Award recipient, Ms. Jo Ann Rogers Todaro? There's that pregnant pause. Can you join me just in giving both of our President's Award recipients a tremendous round of applause? They deserve it. Wes, oh Wes.
I just hide a little bit, 6'5", trying to hide in the corner. Yes.
Hello, doctor.
Hello.
Hello.
What a night.
What an extravagant night. Again, honorees, give yourselves a round of applause. Beautiful night. Had a good time. And most importantly, we were on schedule, which makes everybody happy.
Let me just say to everyone, thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you. Right? Thank you. Those two words, we learned them very early in life, I trust. And we hope that we continue to use them throughout life. Sometimes we take it for granted and it just becomes perfunctory. The email that you receive, you say thank you. The quick hello, you say thank you. But I want you to know from the bottom of my heart, thank you. The lift, the joy, the exuberance, the hope that people are experiencing in this place, that students are experiencing in their classrooms, that was talked about by the visiting team, that they said was palpable when they walked through the campus. It's because of you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for trusting us with vision, with inspiration, with aspiration. Thank you for trusting us with change, knowing how complex and difficult it can be, but trusting that if we stay with it and stay together, we will achieve remarkable outcomes that we have never even imagined. Thank you. We are so grateful to all of our employees, each one of you who is represented here, as well as those that are not in the room tonight. Your contributions are invaluable, and we are grateful. Again, to all of our recipients tonight, congratulations. Congratulations. Right? You are stars. You are stars. And you are shining brightly in the work that you're doing. So don't you be discouraged, because everywhere there's light, darkness is being dispersed. So just keep shining. Just keep shining. I'd also like to extend a special thank you to our Vice President for Equity, Culture, and Talent, Ms. Chanel Whitaker. She could not be here tonight, but also her team. They have led the coordination of this event for the past 3 years. They have culled together volunteers from all across the college. To our technical support staff, who always fall right in to provide that wraparound support. To DJ Heat, would you give it up for DJ Heat? Now let me just say, for the record, can I drop into my Falecia at home voice for a minute? I don't want to see it in them videos. Out there in social media. But anyway, I know y'all already posted it, but DJ Heat had us cutting the rug up in here tonight, so we're thankful for DJ Heat. Okay, the president is back. And yes. For our guest.
Thank you. I'll stay in my bag, too.
Our celebrity guest facilitator and host tonight, Wes Hall. Would you all appreciate him? He is amazing. He is amazing. Again, congratulations to you all. Thank you so much. Thank you to our trustees who are present. Thank you to our senior team members that are present. Thank you to, if you are a family member or a friend, before we leave, a family member who you came out tonight to support someone, would you just stand yes. And be recognized? Yes. Awesome. I'll leave you with this. These are our hidden partners in the work, right? And we know, as we say when our students cross the stage, there are always some hidden partners in the work. Some people who didn't sit in the classroom and complete those assignments, but they were the guinea pigs on a lot of things. And we know that for you, there's some sacrifices that you have made. You've gone without a meal or two, maybe a set of clothes that didn't get ironed exactly the way you wanted them. Who irons anymore? But anyway, you understand. We appreciate you, and we're just so glad that you came to be with us tonight. Again, thank you, and I look forward to greeting all of you all outside in the reception. We certainly hope you'll just stay and linger in it. Remember, tomorrow comes, so linger tonight in this celebratory atmosphere. Congratulations, and thank you so much.
Y'all thought I was going to say something? I can't follow that. Let's go to the reception, have some fun, guys. Great
yes.
Night. Congratulations. Thank you again for the third annual Prince George's Pleasure. County Community College. Down, 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 down